Welcome back to my heat pump journey. In the last video, I went over the first steps I had taken, and that included getting a baseline of my home's energy efficiency, getting an energy performance certificate, and finally having a heat pump survey conducted by Octopus Energy. Well, I have the results of that survey back now, and I'm ready to show you. The surveyor told me it could take up to 14 working days for the results to be sent to me, but they actually sent them through the next day. Here's the breakdown of the room by room heat loss calculations. You can see that they've made assumptions on the required room temperatures, with the bedrooms being 18 degrees and daytime or evening living areas at 21. They've decided that 7 of my radiators need to be upgraded to slightly better ones. This does surprise me actually. I thought they'd need to replace more than that, especially as the bedroom radiators are only P1 or type 10 radiators. Those are the ones with the single panel but no fins at the back. But as you can see, the surveyor was happy with them, but more on that in a minute. What else? Well, they're specifying a 6 kilowatt Daikin heat pump. They'd considered using the smallest 4 kilowatt model, but my home is right on the upper limit of that heat pump if it were performing under ideal conditions. So a 6 kilowatt should still give me a decent scop without risking underperformance in extreme conditions. And for hot water, they're putting in a 250 litre tank, which is massive compared to my current 140 litre tank, but the MCS guidelines say that for a 4-bedroom house with a bathroom and an ensuite, you fit a 250 litre tank. Now, this is all very interesting, but how should I or anyone go about verifying if what they're saying is accurate? Well, you should always get multiple quotes, so as at the very least you can compare them. But there's also a rule of thumb. The Protons for Breakfast blog proposed that if you have a gas boiler, you should take your annual gas usage and divide it by 2,900. Now, there are several articles on that blog which discuss where that figure of 2,900 comes from, but for now, let's see what happens with my data. Using my trusty Hildebrand Glow and Home Assistant, I have been recording my gas usage for the past 12 months. You can see here that I used 6,847 kilowatt hours of energy from gas over 12 months. If I divide that by 2,900, I get a result of 2.36. So I'd need a heat pump with an output power of 2.36 kilowatts in order to heat my home. If you're thinking, well, that sounds ridiculously low, then you'd be right. The thing is, I've broken the formula. Over the last couple of years, I've spent a huge amount of time and effort reducing how much gas I'm using. I installed a Honeywell Evo Home multi-room heating control system many years ago, and that has given me the ability to fine-tune exactly how we heat our home. Through monitoring and experimenting, I figured out the most efficient way to heat my home. For example, rather than just heat the rooms just in time for when I needed them warm, I'd actually warm all rooms at the same time. Then I'd set different rooms to reduce their set point at different times. One big effort to heat the whole house in one go used less energy than heating various rooms at different times. I guess the system must have overheads, meaning getting a specific room up to temperature on its own is less efficient. I also reduced the set points to 19 or 20 degrees during the evenings, 16 degrees overnight, and I stopped using gas to heat the hot water too. We've been running purely on eddy boosts, apart from the occasional full tank from the boiler for a bath or when we have visitors. Oh, and a crafty little automation to turn off the heating if the doors are left open for more than 5 minutes. It's difficult to measure how much energy that has saved me, but it triggers several times a week. So if my low usage broke the formula, what should I do? Well, the estimate from Octopus on how much gas I should be using for this size of house is 13,000 kilowatt hours. I don't have any old bills or data that I can use, but from memory of before I optimized everything, that value seems ballpark accurate. If I use 13,000 kilowatt hours and divide that by 2,900, I get a value of 4.4 kilowatts. So a 4.4 kilowatt heat pump. This is sounding more like the logic from Octopus. they advised me that the 4 kilowatt heat pump could provide, under optimum conditions, up to 4.7 kilowatts. There's not a lot of tolerance there, so a 6 kilowatt heat pump has been specified instead. I think I'm quite happy with that sizing, to be honest. It's not massively overspecked with a 9 or 11 kilowatt heat pump. I'm no expert in any of this, I must point out. I'm learning all of this as I go along, so somebody in the comments is bound to point out that it's the wrong choice, and there's going to be opinions in all directions. What was that you say? You want even more data? Okay, go back over to the Protons for Breakfast blog, and there's a spreadsheet called HTC Estimator. This spreadsheet has loads of tabs, so you're best off working through the instructions on the associated blog post, but I'm going to whiz through them here to show you quickly. First tab. In this whole spreadsheet, you only change values in the yellow fields. You set your desired temperature set points. I've said 18 degrees during the day, 20 in the morning and evening, and then 16 degrees at night. On the second tab, for hot water, I filled in how many people live in the house, which is 4, and let it guess at how much energy I'd need for that. On the third tab, I've stuck in 13,000 kilowatt hours of full year gas usage in here, because basically my reading of 6,847 really breaks things. I left the boiler efficiency and outside design temperature alone, then chose my nearest location from the location dropdown. Finally, I set the household floor area. You can already see that it's saying I need a heat pump size of 3.8 kilowatts, so again, we're in the 4 kilowatt ballpark. Now we're going to look at the radiators, and the fourth tab is where you set the temperature drop across each radiator and the maximum flow temperature you'd like to use. I've left it at the defaults with a 50 degree flow temperature. And on the fifth tab, I've defined all of the radiators. These here are the radiators as specified by Octopus with their changes, rather than the actual ones I have at the moment. What is interesting here are those output powers for bedrooms 1, 2 and 3. This spreadsheet has calculated the heating powers of those radiators, and the values are 25 to 30% lower than the calculations from Octopus, meaning that these three rooms have radiators with a lower power output than their heat loss. I'll need to do some more research on this and find out why there is such a discrepancy. I have to get back to you on that one. Well, what does this show us then? Well, it shows us that the radiators as specified are sufficient to heat my home, achieving 131% of the actual target. It doesn't actually tell me if it's sufficient to heat each room, which is a shame. Finally, the summary tab. You can fill in your energy rates here and it'll give you an idea of how much you'll save and how much extra it'll cost you to run this system. And it'll estimate your reduction in CO2 emissions too. I'll stick links to the spreadsheet down in the video's description so you can try this out for yourself. On to planning permission then. Why do I need planning permission when heat pumps are generally considered permitted development? If we take a look at the planning permission guidance for Wales, I want to point out two things. Firstly, where it says no part of the air source heat pump can be installed within 3 metres of the boundary of your property. In England, that says 1 metre of the boundary of your property. So this is the location of where I plan to put the heat pump, and you can see it's only 2.2 metres away from the boundary fence. Secondly, this part at the start about making sure that it complies with the MCS planning standards or equivalent standards. That part is quite crucial and something I didn't fully understand to start with until I spoke to Octopus about it. Basically, in order to get the boiler upgrade grant, they must comply with MCS standards. And one of those requirements is that if there is a line of sight between the heat pump and a neighbouring property's windows, then planning permission must be obtained. This diagram shows the location plan of my home, with the boundary outlined in red. I've stuck a red block roughly where the heat pump will sit, and you can see that although it's a very shallow angle, it still has line of sight to the rear of my neighbour's home. So planning permission is needed then. This was quite a daunting process to me, having never been through a planning application before. I called up the local authority first to find out what they actually needed, then contacted Octopus for the information. A nice guy from Octopus actually sat with me, virtually on a screen share, and helped me with the application and provided me with all of the required information. I had to buy a plan for my property and then put together a site plan showing the dimensions and locations of everything. This is the part I'm not totally confident about. I'm really not sure if I've done this correctly or not, but I've tried to be as accurate as possible. And that's that. Planning application submitted, and it's now a waiting game. I'm really hoping they reply soon to say it's approved, but I have a feeling that there's going to be a bit of back and forth on this. Anyway, please give the video a like and subscribe to my channel to find out what happens next. I'll update you on the progress when I have more news. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.